your TV.
Take me to church.
Hello. Hello, welcome to COS. Please, if you want, switch off the microphone because all this meeting here is going to be recorded and uploaded to YouTube channel of Municipality of COS in order to have, if you want, specific parts of the video in order to use it wherever you want. So, my name is David Zeraskles. I'm Deputy Mayor of COS Town. My colleague here, Mr. Antonis Kritikos, is the president of the Municipal Council of COS. And on behalf of all the members of the Municipal Council and especially the mayor of COS, Mr. Giorgos Kiritsis, I want to welcome you once again, many of you, here to COS Town Hall in order to have a discussion about the very interesting issues you have in your program. I want to thank especially the principal of Second Lyceum of COS, Mr. Chlapanis, because of his hard efforts and hard work, COS Town is among a very specific number of towns, of cities all over Europe, that because of this program is well known for very interesting issues we are going to face as European citizens, now and for the future. We have, as usual, because you have to know that this is the fifth time we are going, we have, you are not sure. So, many of you, especially the teachers, I see my friend from Poland here, I have a very specific proposal for you. You are going to be a citizen of COS Town, because... an honorary citizen of COS Town, and we have some very little presents for each of you in order to remember your visit here, and of course I'm at your disposal to discuss whatever you want, what about your the issues you are examining in the project, or whatever you think that you have to ask about COS Town, the policies of the municipality, of course, concerning the environment, the climate change, whatever. So, once again, welcome, and thank you very much for your presence here.
Thank you.
Okay. I want to, when each one of you, you want to speak, you have to push the button here in order for the cameras to zoom to you, okay? Don't.
I think that we will not speak.
Okay.
I would like to thank Mr. Yaraskles, of course, the mayor, but also Mr. Yaraskles and Mr. Kritikos, who are always helping us in these projects and in all these meetings. They are really interested in our work, and this is very beneficial for everybody. So I speak on behalf of the whole school community. Thank you very much. And also, we have also had some help already during our meeting with the buses, with everything. And I think it honors everybody to be here. So we do have students should have prepared some questions. In a while, I think this is for them to ask you about several matters. And also, they were also interested, and we have arranged a visit to the hotspot because of our the problem we faced, especially in 2015. But generally speaking, of how you are handling it, we are handling it as a municipality. So they might also ask about this after that, but also about our program. I would like you to also to ask Mr. Max Michel to say just a few things about our project, maybe if you like. We have Mr. Max Michel from Denmark, Pavel, Ada, and Aneta from Poland, as you well know. Yes, of course. Yes. We have to tell everybody, although most of you know, that Mr. Yerasklis also is a parent hosting. He's helping in many times. definitely. I think you are already. Okay, and we have also Nick and Marlene from UK. And also we have, who have I forgotten? No, this is it for countries. All right, so I don't know if you want Mikkel to say.
Mr. Kritikos, by the way, is a colleague of yours. He's a teacher also at the Mahia High School. Wants to say something about the meeting. I'm going to translate if okay.
Εκ μέρους του Δημοτικού Συμβουλίου του Δήμου της Κόνα, καλωσορίσω τους συνοδούς και τα παιδιά συνέδρια του Δημοτικού Συμβουλίου. Να τους πω ότι σε αυτή την αίθουσα και οι μαθητές των σχολείων της ΚΟΕ έρχονται και τους εξηγούμε το πώς λειτουργεί το Δημοτικό Συμβουλίο. Να τους ευχηθώ καλή παραμονή στο νησί, αν και ο καιρός μάλλον δεν βοήθησε πάρα πολύ, αλλά θεωρώ ότι τους μείνει αξέχαστη το τριήμερο, πενθήμερο, πόσο καιρό μένουν εδώ. Και θα φύγουν μια εβδομάδα και θα φύγουν με τις καλύτερες αναμνήσεις από το νησί μας.
Okay. So, among the welcome issues, as I told you in the beginning, the most important thing that Mr. President said is that this place here, this room here, is used by the schools of KOS in order to practice in democracy, let's say, because here is the local, let's say, the temple of democracy. Okay, so many friends of yours, many students of the schools, of course, use this place in order to examine different things and different issues. And of course, Mr. President, wish you a very nice stay in Kos Island, and hopefully the weather is not helping so much, but I'm pretty sure, and Mr. President also is sure, that you are going to have a very nice time here in Kos. Okay.
Magic happens.
We are very well aware of the new technology.
Yes, we don't have this in Denmark. I want one for myself back home and my family. Everybody, listen to your father. So, the ultimate scope of our project is climate change and how to tackle that. We've been focusing a lot on alternative energy and not least how to store this alternative energy, because it is such a hyper-complex mechanism. We used to be just a few actors on the stage, one power plant here, one power plant there. Now there are literally millions and millions of actors on the scene, and we all have to speak together to make one European grid. It is very complex, as you all know. What we've been doing is actually to try to look at Europe from a helicopter and see what do we need here. That is complex. But we can also scale it down and look at the very small local communities, such as KOS, because that's not easy either. Now you are on a small island. How do you? I have several questions for you. How do you manage? Where do you get your electricity from? And how do you think you'll be getting that in 50 years' time, 30 years' time?
I will answer right now if you want to close your microphone, because, you know, Mr. President here has a difficult job because everyone wants to speak and the camera's going around if you don't close the microphone. So, thank you for your question. The main problem we have here, according to your issue, as you said it, it's that Kos is, and all the islands of Greece, is not connected in the main grid. This is very difficult in order to promote renewable energy sources. But there is a complex of islands that the power comes from the main power station, which is located in Mastihari, in Kos, just beneath the airport. Maybe you noticed it, which has an output of approximately 100 megawatts, and it is working in fuel. But also, there is approximately 25 megawatts on renewable energy sources, which is 20 megawatts of wind turbines located in the western side of Kos Island, and mainly, and of course there is another plant up to the mountain of Vikios in Pili area, and the rest of 5 megawatts is from solar power. There is a big project concerning the connection to the main grid of mainland Greece, but right now is concluded in the Kyklades Islands. And afterwards, probably there is going to be a connection between Crete and Rhodes, and from Rhodes we have to be all together in this grid, and for sure the connection with from Crete to Peloponnesos is going to be implemented afterwards. We have, as you noticed, not right now because the weather is, we have many possibilities on improving the use of renewable energy sources, not only in from the wind, but mainly from the sun. Because we have many days around year, approximately, usually, not this year. This year is an exception. But usually we have above 300 days of sunny days all over the year. So we are going to, as for sure, as a municipality, we are working on such issues, but in a smaller scale. It is not our, let's say, issue according to the law to resolve and have some specific issues resolved about the energy production here in Kos, but we mainly implement specific small-scale programs. One of each is concerning the behavior of the buildings in order to make it more energy prone. And one of these buildings is the High School of Antimachia. It is going to be a program there from a program of European Union, which is between Greece and Cyprus. I don't remember the exact name of the program, but it's between the cooperation between countries which have the same borders in the European Union, and one of these programs is about this improvement of the building of the high school, and one other building in which is municipality run and has specific services of the municipality. But for sure, the climate change issue is a very big issue. We have another big problem, which is the corrosion of the coast all over the island, which is very it is the rhythm of getting bigger and bigger. This problem is very, you are going to have, maybe you saw, there is a project going on down to the sea here in Coast Town, which before 10 years ago, there was a beach there with a width of 50 meters, and now the sea is on the wall of the, and we have very, very big issues. And we are working in order to resolve, them. But there are many the projects, the works that have to be done is very cost. The cost is very high, and we have to find specific funds in order to implement these projects. I don't know if I covered their, your question, but this is the main things we have as a municipality. Leah, because she's asking me in home, okay?
And I,
ah, okay. Ah.
Currently holding back the most cost from using renewable energy and or replacing the fossil fuel generator you had with renewable energy?
I think that you are from UK. No? You are from Denmark, because you're, you speak like from someone from the UK, and you have to speak a little bit slower, in, because, okay.
What is holding back costs from using renewable energy instead of using the fossil fuel, what's it called, generator that you have under the airport?
I already told that the main problem is we are not connected in the main grid. So if we use more renewable energy sources, we have to have a specific method, a specific in order to store the power. Because the power that comes from the renewable energy sources has to be consumed right away. This is the main problem. The main problem is this, and that's why we have this limitation of 25 megawatts concerning the whole power, which is 125. It's approximately one-fourth of the total power, one-fifth. And you have to know that during the winter months that we don't have more consumption, much consumption as the summertime, usually, the power of the renewable energy sources are enough in order to cover our needs.
So you're saying that there is like no place to store the energy that it's produced, and if it's produced, it may not be used like 100% of it.
The winter months that we don't have, as I told you, the consumption is mainly low. Sometimes the operator has to cut the power from the wind turbines because they don't have the ability nor to when it produced. Maybe it is a complicated technical issue, but this is the if the consumption is low, you can have renewable energy sources like wind turbines or solar panels in the grid. You have to consume the power at the same time you produce it.
Yes, what we've been looking at partly is to take water and put it into the mountains, right? And you have mountains.
Yes.
Do you think you would that be a solution for you?
You are talking about, let's say, this is called a hybrid system. This is the proper... No. We used to consume the power of renewable energy sources in order to to elevate a specific amount in water in a high level in order to use it afterwards when we are going to need it. This is a very big, as you consider, it's a very big project that it is not in the area of our power as a municipality to implement such big projects. Probably it is more convenient and more cost effective to connect the islands in the main grid. So when we are going to be connected in the main grid, all this, let's say, surplus of power we are producing from renewable energy sources is going to be diverted in the main grid, and we solve the problem.
Do you think that it will take for our island and actually all of the surrounding islands to be connected to the main grid?
In the first answer, that there is a complex of islands that is connected by a sea cable with the main power plant of Kos Island. It is Tilos and Nisiros in the south, of Kos, and Kalymnos, Leros and Lipsi Island in the north, of Kos. So, if we are going to connect, as I told you, Kos with Rhodes and Crete is going to be connected with Peloponnesos, we are going to solve this problem. I think that the rhythm that this kind of issues resolved, we are going to be able to say that this is going to be ready in 10 years' time.
Currently storing energy on costs.
How?
Are you currently storing energy on costs?
We are not stored any kind of energy right away as they produce it.
Yes, sorry. So this is a more political question, and it's kind of tricky.
Yes.
Getting.
We have elections right now. We have faced many tricky questions.
Okay, but this is really tricky.
Yes.
So one of the things that we've been trying to teach you is that getting power or electricity long distances makes for a big loss. You simply lose a lot of energy if you try to get it all the way from mainland Greece here.
Yes.
But there's another country really close to you.
Yes. Very, very logical question. But you have to ask other persons, because we, as a municipality, like all the municipalities, we are not have any kind of connection with international policy affairs and all these things. As you know, this region of the Earth, it is going to be a very hot region in the near future, because there are many, they found some specific areas that has natural gas beneath the sea near Cyprus. Probably you heard that. There are some issues that said that there are going to be some big pipes that you are going to move the gas, this gas to the Europe, from beginning from Egypt, Israel, going to Cyprus, then Greece, and then Italy. So it is going to be very difficult issues. And for sure, we as a municipality of last ones, we have to take care of these issues. Okay. About nightlife in Kos. Yeah? No. You are not. I'm going to ask you a tricky question. What about this Brexit issue? Eh? No one is going to.
We are all Remainers. That's what you have to know. We are all for Remain in the EU. Yeah, we are all for Remain. I speak for everyone. Speak for yourself. Then.
Of an issue is climate change in general in Kos and in Greece. Like how big of an importance is it to the voters? Yeah.
There is, let's say, a specific interest of not, and hopefully not to the majority of the people. Majority of the people has other consider them as more interesting and more vital. Probably they are, if you facing a very big line on the economics and you have issues of unemployment, of, you know, this is going in the line and waiting for the result. But I suppose that the big majority of people, because of the new means of information and all these things, the new technology, are well aware of the importance of this issue, the climate change. Sorry, because I speak to them in order, because they vote this year, you know. So, what do you think about the total, the whole situation here in Kos? I make the questions because I know, I see that there is no interest from you. Eh?
Yeah, I think it hasn't changed much. That's why we're not that, like, we don't care about it that much. But when it starts to really change and affect our tourism, which is like our main, source of income, then things will get heated.
The main issue we are facing is the corrosion of the coastline. This is the biggest problem right now. Not the the more use of renewable energy sources and to stop use fuel in order to produce our energy. This is going to be the main problem because we lose a territory, vital territory, and it is the scale of the problem is higher and higher every year, year by year. As the girl there said, we have as the main industry here in Kos, the tourism. So if we are losing the beaches, it is going to be for tourism issues, as you know.
Hello.
Hello.
A few years ago, you saw what a refugee situation could be like, and what the projections say is that it keeps getting harder which means that in many of the countries that are right now producing refugees and immigrants, it will be getting much, much, much hotter and also probably unbearable, which means that if it gets much hotter, you will see more immigrants and refugees from war or simple migration. And what's your take on that?
I'm pretty sure that in the near future we are going to have refugees because of the climate change, not because of the wars only. This is something that is going to be to happen for sure, I suppose. But I think that the refugee issue is one of the main issues we have to realize that we are going to face it as a European Union. If we leave the problem to Greece, to Italy, to Turkey, to specific countries, this problem is without any kind of solution. So I think that you are going to have a visit to the hotspot. Well, I don't know when. You are going to find one of the best situation concerning the other similar installations at the other islands. Let's say Mytilene, Chios and Samos facing real big problems. Hopefully here we have the situation, the Greek state, because it is a very complicated issue and a very difficult issue for a municipality to handle. So the state has to take care of it. So you are going to see one of the best, I suppose, installations for refugees and migrants from all over Greece. But the problem is real big. And for sure, if we don't have this cooperation as countries of the European Union and take under consideration that we have to be involved, each country, and according to their capabilities, for sure. We are not going to wait to ask from small countries like Greece to solve the problem and have other bigger countries that they are not taking care of this situation. For sure, we faced a very difficult situation during the summer of 2015, mainly because of the absence, total absence, not only from the Greek state, which is, as I told you, responsible to handle this, but even from European Union also. When we asked for help from the Greek state, from the European Union, they thought that maybe this is a very big, a very little, very small issue, and it is going to be addressed in the usual ways. And hopefully, this produced very challenging issues, especially in the summer of 2015, when we have here, you know, the population of Kos Island is 33,000 people. During August of 2015, in Kos Town, we have 20,000 people in the streets. In the streets, of course. So you realized what happened and what effort needed in order to overcome this issue. And concerning the outcome of this this problem, that our approach to this big this sorry ah this problem it was the right one.
Hi. How do you reckon the refugee crisis has affected life in Kos and the islands around, and Greece as well, actually?
Because I know about Kos, I don't know what is the problem at other areas of Greece. I know for sure that the installations that host migrants and refugees in the islands I mentioned before, Mytilene, Chios and Samos, the they are facing a very, very difficult issues in the way they host these people and the way they provide specific and basic services to these people. But here in Kos, as we mentioned before, we have a local economy that depends on tourism. So you can realize when in the streets, the main streets of Kos town, we had 20,000 people living in the streets. And the next year we faced a decline of approximately 15% in the tourist arrivals. But hopefully, because of specific policies we implement, the year after and the last year, we managed to overcome this bad situation, and we are going to face better situations concerning this.
I would like to thank you for all the answers. I would like to ask you, you are already invited, of course, and you will present, I think what you mentioned about the storage of the energy and the problem that we face is exactly at the heart of the problem, and it's exactly the subject of our project. So this is something you can say on Thursday when you will come, because this is exactly what we need, and thank you. And of course, Mr. Kritikos, you are invited, and anybody from the municipality council who wants to come, the mayor, of course, and everybody else, can come on Thursday, because we have this conference, this whole day event about all these matters, and all the students will present part of their job. They're still working. We have a workshop. They will go on and work right after lunch and continue and be ready to present there. And finally, I would like to say that we're going to visit the hotspot on Friday, so they will see some things, and I think there's a balance now, right now. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you for being here. All the best. We are waiting each one of you in the near future. Let's make a wish that maybe you are going to find us in the same positions after the elections. Okay. Thank you very much again. Good luck.